Hello, my friends. Let's talk about the continuum about the modeling with minimization type problems. But let me remind you, by the end of this month, it is about, I think, 26th, we'll have the midterm exam. After this, we'll have the midterm exam about 26 or someone will get contact with you, and you will be sure about the date. So what will be included at the midterm exam? You will be responsible all the things that we have seen up to now, which is the general introduction of operation research, why and how it is used, and also the formulation modeling will be, and solution using by graphical solution method. Today I'm going to give you another example, which is diet problem. This is an example modeling. This is the diet problem. And try to explain you this. There is a farm that uses at least how much? 800 pounds of special feed for the animals. Daily. This is daily. Daily feed that should be given to the animals. Be careful about here. It says at least. The special feed is a mixture of corn and soybean. Corn and soybean are mixed and make this special feed. These are the ingredients. The composition is like this. These are called as feed stuff. These are the stuff. Let's say feed stuff over here. And this feed stuff, corn, we need protein for the animals, and we need fiber for the animals. For each pound of the corn, how much protein we have? We have 0.09 tons of lepra per, right, which is pound per pound, is, and for each pound of corn, we have 0.025. For the soybean, it is 60.60 lipra of protein for each kilogram of soybean, and the fiber is 0.06. And also what is given us? The cost. The cost is in dollar, let's say, per pound, which is for each pound, it is $0.30 and $0.90. This is the definition. At the exam, you will see such kind of problem, so be careful and listen. The dietary requirement, there is a requirement of the special feed. It says that at least it is needed 30% should be protein, and at most, be careful, at most 5% fiber. What does it mean? It means it can contain more than 30% of the protein, but not more than 5% of the fiber. So Özark Farm, this is an example from your book, and Özark Farm, we should determine daily minimum cost. What is our objective? Objective is the daily minimum cost feed mix. In other words, how much corn and how much soybean to be used. So let's see what's going on. We said that first define the decision variables. Our decision variables means unknown. So let's say x1 is equal to corn used daily in lepra, and x2 is soybean used daily in that special feed. So after saying that, our objective function we have to write. Due to that, it is cost. This is the first, do the, that one. Secondly, this is the first, define decision variables. Secondly, objective function. Let's say Z, use Z, no problem. It is the total daily cost in dollar. So what is our objective? Our objective is to minimum cost. So it is minimize Z, which is equal to how much corn will be used, X1. What is the unit cost? 0.30. Plus, how much is the soybean? It is X2. We define it over here. So daily X2 is the quantity and 0.90. So this is our objective function. And thirdly, we have to define the constraints. Constraints. What are the constraints? The constraints are this. The how much, at least it says, is the special feed. So what is the substance? What is the mix in that feed? It is the corn and soybean. So the it means X1 plus X2 that we are going to mix them should be greater or equal to 800. At least we need that amount, so it should be greater or equal to. Don't be careful. Don't make that one smaller or equal to, because it means that in that case it can be zero or something. So this should be at least 800. Let's say this is the special feed constraint. What about the protein constraint? Protein constraint says that it is over here, at least this amount should be. So protein, for that protein, if we use X1, which is the corn, for each pound we get 0.09, plus for each kilogram of soybean we get how much? 0.60. This quantity should be at least should be greater or equal to the amount of feed that will be used is X1 plus X2, which is 0.30 is the at least. So that is the formula. And if we multiply these two, it will be 0.3 X1 plus 0.3 X2. If we take this other side, it will be like that. Minus 0.21 X1 plus 0.30 X2, which will be greater or equal to zero. So this is our protein constraint. What about fiber constraint? Fiber constraint, let's see. For each kilogram of, let's say, fiber constraint for it, it is 0.02. X1 plus for soybean that will be used X2, it will be 0.06, and that should be says at most. So this should be smaller or equal to 0.005 multiplied by X1 plus X2 is the amount of let's say fiber. This part should be less than this quantity. So if we multiply them, we'll get like this, 0.05 X1 plus 0.05 X2. If we take them other side, it will be what? It will be minus 0.03 X1 plus 0.1 X2, which will be smaller or equal to zero, as you see over here. And that is the fiber constraint. So what else? Let's see, let me write over here, complete model will be as like this. Our objective function is over there. It means minimize total cost, which is Z, which is equal to 0.3 x1 plus 0.9 x2. You know that 0.030 and 0.3 is same. It is not different, which is subject to the constraints. The special fit constraint is x1 plus x2, which is greater or equal to 800, which is the special fit. The protein constraint says that minus 0.21 x1 plus 0.30 x2, that should be greater or equal to 0. And last one is minus 0.03 x1 plus 0.01 x2, which is smaller or equal to 0. And don't forget to write the non-negativity constraints, which is x1 greater or equal to 0, x2 greater or equal to 0. So this is our complete model for this problem. Now, as you see, this is the complete model, so this is not anymore needed. I'm going to erase this part. And the question is, how we have to solve this problem? You can use now graphical solution method for it. What is important? Again, as we did before, we'll use the coordinate axis like that. Put over here x1, over here x2. You know, that is the, it is defined over here, is the cone used in that special fit daily. And x2 is the soybean that is used over here. And if you want to solve this, again, same method should be used, such as you have to assume x1 plus x2 equal to 800. That means if x1 is equal to 0, the other will be assume. This is assumption. Assume. First assume. And the other, if it is 0, it means 800. So you say this one, let's assume that this is 800 over here, and this is 800 over here. You draw the line. The question is this. I said you use the origin. This is the origin, 0, 0. And check if, listen, this is greater. Is x1, 0 plus 0 greater than 800? No. So it can't be this side. It should be other side, the feasible region, I mean. So here, that is, and this area is now. This area is not anymore feasible region. This area is. But we have two more constraints, namely this one. Let's take one of it. I'm going to use this part for it, which is minus 0.21 x1 plus 0.30 x2 equal assume. First, assume that it is equal to that. So if x1 is equal to 0, x2 will be equal to 0. What it means? It means that line, which is the protein constraint, passing through the origin. So we need one more point. What is that point? Let's say if x1 is equal to 300, x2 should be equal to how much? 210. Why? This is, if you put 300 over here, 210 over here, multiplied, it will be 0. So that one is 300. 0, 0 is here. 300 is, this is 400. 300 over here. The other is 210. The point that is intersecting over here is the point. If you join this line, it gives you the equation. But which side? Is it that side or that side feasible area? You have to use checkpoint. We cannot use checkpoint as the origin. Why? Because it is passing through origin. Just take any point where, just here. Say 1000 point, x1 is 1000, is, you have to say, minus 210 multiplied by 1000, it makes this. Smaller than 0, because it is, or is it greater? Yeah, it is greater. Is it greater than 0? Is minus 210 greater than 0 this side? No. So it should be other side, not this side. The other side should be. So the second one, if we use, it is again same. If that is equal to 0, the other should be equal to 0. It is passing over here. And if they are equal, let's say the other point, if x1 is equal to 100, the other should be equal to 300. This is a point. 100 and 200 means this is 100 and that is 300 will be over here. So it means that, it means this, it will passing through that point over there. And as you see, this will be oversight, this that side, and the feasible solution region is in this area. You have to check it. Now, to find the optimal solution, you have to try this point and that point, because it is minimization. And for using the objective function, either you find at point, let's say A and B, which one is better, smaller. And you can see that the objective function that we are going to use for minimization problems, you have to draw it, give a line, and this will be for minimization, you have to shift it toward origin. And the last point nearest to the origin is the optimal solution, and you have to compare and find it. So that is the last point that you will be responsible at the midterm exam. I'm going to say once more, you will be responsible about the definitions, what we have seen up to now as a summary, introduction parts, and why we are doing it, what is more important. The second, let's say, midterm will be one, definitions. The second one is the modeling. This modeling will be linear programming models. And the third one is the solution with graphical solution method are the topics that you are responsible. After the midterm, we are going to see how to solve this with simplex method and the transportation models. Thank you very much.